In this video, I will show you how to create a scene like this from scratch. First, start with a sphere. Make it smaller and set its type to hexahedron with 9 segments. That gives a low poly sphere with nice topology. Make it editable and scale the lower vertices in Y, like this. Create a subdivision surface object and use the sphere as its child. Scale the shape a little bit until you are happy. Next, create a plane and move the drop if necessary. Duplicate the drop and give every drop a different shape. This is a good starting point. Create 2 U-render materials, rename them and assign them to the objects. Change your layout and activate U-render Live to get a real-time preview of the scene. Create a null object and an area light. Parent the light under the null object and move the area light in negative Z direction. Create a light tag for the area light and start to place your light source as you like using position and rotation. Set the attenuation of the light to inverse square and adjust the radius decay value. Set the shadow mode to hard at first and adjust the absolute and slope bias to decrease the artifacts. Set the shadow map size to a higher resolution. Switch to soft edges and reduce the sample radius to define the softness of the shadow. Roughly adjust the glossiness of the materials. Open the render settings and go to environment and choose a HDR image as global environment map. Activate Diffuse IPL. Go to Effects and activate Screen Space Ambient Occlusion. Go back to environment and deactivate User's Background. Adjust the exposure values. Under Basic Settings, choose the Anti-Aliasing Mode FXAA. This method has excellent performance. Now load some textures into the materials for the plane. Diffuse, glossiness, roughness and normal map are a good start to get nice materials. For this example, I choose a green color for the ground and set the mix mode to add or multiply. You also can use the brightness, contrast, gamma sliders to make basic color corrections for the texture. Tweaking the reflectance can greatly change the appearance of the scene. If light and the materials are roughly set up, it's time to activate tone mapping to prevent highlights burning out too much. Normally I prefer exponential tone mapping, but in this scene Reinhardt works better. Now I'm going to set up the drops. I connect the drops to one single mesh. This is not really necessary in this case, but it helps with scene performance. First, I try to find a base color. Maybe it's a good idea to use a complementary color. Next, switch to metallic workflow and adjust the metalness value. Note that dielectric materials like plastic, wood or stone have a low value and conducting materials, all kind of metals, a higher value. In the next step, we fake some additional light by using the emissive channel. First, change the mapping to spherical. Find a nice color and hue shift it a little bit compared to the base color. Add a noise and set mix mode to add or multiply. Next, choose a noise texture you like. Booyah has some nice shapes. Adjust the brightness of the emissive channel. To add a little bit more detail, raise the octaves of the noise. Because we use a Cinema 4D shader, it has to be baked. You can adjust the baking resolution in the render settings. Now let's see what additional effects we can use to improve the rendering. Chromatic aberration and vignette provide a more photo-like appearance. A little bit of bloom can also add some additional atmosphere. Note that multi-frame sampling can influence the performance, but in this case the scene performs very well. Open the render settings and go to reflectance. Activate the screen space reflections. They need to be activated in each material too. Use the exposure slider to adjust the strength of the reflections. Now create a camera, set it as active and apply a new render camera tag. Also adjust the near and far clipping values. Open the render settings and activate depth of field. Adjust the focus distance and the f-stop. For the next step, we are going to create some shadow casting planes to get a more interesting result. Create a new U-Render material. This texture contains an alpha channel, so set the channel from luminance to alpha. Adjust the threshold if needed. Create a plane and assign the shadow material. Activate U-Render Live and begin to position the plane until you like the shadow. Duplicate a plane and keep on positioning. A activate multi-frame sampling and find a nice perspective. Well done!